Nathan Smith against Nolan Walker. And here we go in the semifinals of the Frozen Four. Puck of the ice. Shot taken there off the stick of McKay into the corner. Huskies try to work it back. Got a look. Second shot going to go. And St. Cloud State will get a power play marker. And they'll get on the board first. I believe Spencer Meyer was the guy out of Sartell. And he had a rebound opportunity, John. He had an opening to shoot. And there was no chance for Dryden McKay. Played out to the point. Kept in by Hirose on the screen. Knocked down out front. Mavericks get it back and they score! Nathan Smith, hash mark, left. He scores and the Mavericks have tied it. Power play goal with 47 seconds to spare on the board.
Hirose with a shot from the point. Smith was helpful getting it out to him. Took it to the center, put it on net. Blocked by, I think, a Husky. And there's Nathan Smith at the hash marks. He whips it home. We're tied.
Well, and you know, Mike, the Mavericks just... Like I said, I mean, overmatched, obviously not, but...
Here come the Huskies, and they give it right back. Wow, Minnesota State did not cover Kyler Kupka. He was all alone on the blocker side of the net. There was nobody there.
No, there was no one
there. They passed it up, and there was a breakdown somewhere, and the Mavericks paid dearly for that. Cockrell throws it behind the Minnesota State net, follows up. Carroll breaks it up defensively. Then a Provnik who threw it back, picked off. Here's a shot, and he scores. Mavericks with a defensive breakdown, and again, they turn it over, and they pay for it dearly. Will Hammer hammers it home, the St. Cloud native, and the Mavericks now down by a pair. Second time, Minnesota State with a breakdown, and that was just a passing turnover.
Yep, Napravnik picks up. Andy Carroll pushes it up along the far boards, along about the half boards. Napravnik picks it up, backhands it, thinking there's a defender back in the dot. No one was there, not any Mavericks. Will Hammer was there, the senior from St. Cloud. He buries it, and it's a 3-1 game.
Does a nice job of getting out of a hole. Worked it ahead to Ahmed. Ahead now to Dallas. Gerads feeds off the left wing. Here's Carroll into the zone. Drop feed. Gerads right out of the rebound. Score! Walker Door coming in up the right wing. And Rennick never had a chance. Minnesota State pulls within one. Walker Door cocks his arm and hey, here we go.
How about that? Andy Carroll takes the pass. He's a defenseman. Down the left side. Backhand pass to Dallas Gerads. He puts it on net. Rebound to the far dot where Walker Door backhands it in, and the Mavericks are back in this.
Oh, boy, they cannot get this power play started. Yep, Bobolkov has been out in the neutral zone or back in the Maverick end. Here we go off the half wall now. Picked up by Smith. Got a look, and he scores! Nathan Smith! See if anybody else is able to tack that. Is that one?
I think Sam Morton might have dug that off the side boards.
Well, Smith's going to get it. He's going to go through.
Oh, yeah, Smith gets it.
And Nathan Smith getting his second power play goal of the game. And Minnesota State reviving themselves and come back with a power play marker here at 14:23 of the middle period.
Yeah, so it was Morton who just at the half boards, just down to our left, kind of scoops it off the boards. Nathan swoops in, picks it up at the top of the circle, skates to farther to center, to the center, and I think Rennick may have been screened by Kyler Kupka because then he just rips that hard wrist shot. It goes. We're tied.
So a big win for the Mavericks right there. Minnesota State deadlocks this game for the first time. And let's see where we'll go from here. Mavericks now beginning to generate that second period. There's a backhand out front. Mavericks trying to jam it in with Sandelin. Rennick will finally get control. A breakdown there by the Huskies. Minnesota State quickly moved it out in front of the net, and Ryan Sandelin trying to jam it in on Rennick here in the near post. 15:52 to go in regulation. 3-3 our score. 21-16 shots favor MSU. They bring it into the zone. Walker Door out front, and the Mavericks score! Walker Door played that into the corner, and Minnesota State finished it off in front of the net. Was it Dallas Gerads that did it? And I believe it was. Dallas. Dallas came in off the left wing, and Doerr eyeballed him in all the way, and then he gave it, and Gerads finishes the play, and for the first time in this game, Minnesota State forges ahead 4-3.
Three unanswered for the Mavericks. It was Jake Livingstone just at the Mavericks' blue line. He picks it up at the near boards, chips it ahead to Dallas. Dallas chips it ahead to Doerr, and then breaks. And Duer takes it down the right side. It's 2-on-1. He sends it to the slot. There's the left-hander, Dallas Gerads, to just steer it past David Rennick and the Mavericks with the 4-3 lead.
Minnesota State with a one-goal advantage at 4-3, and you better believe they're going to try to camp on it. They want another goal.
And what I was going to say, Mike, was you're going to see a lot of dumps behind the defense. Make them play it. See if they can get out clean. If not, press.
Well, there's a bouncing puck, and the Huskies get it in, and we're all tied up.
Just like that.
Definitely dangerous waters right now. Mavericks want to get control, but it's the Huskies that get it. They'll take a shot, and they score!
Donahue with the shot from the point and the tip.
Well, that's going to go.
By Nolan Walker.
Yeah, Nolan Walker. He's a junior out of Anchorage.
It's just a good play by the Huskies. The Mavericks couldn't clear. And the hard, low shot and the tip. Dryden McKay doesn't have a chance on that one.
That coming at 19:07. Stone right side. They missed in the hookup with Borchardt. 5 seconds to go. Somebody needs to shoot. That'll get knocked down, and St. Cloud State will eliminate Minnesota State as they'll come from behind and defeat the Mavericks by a final score of 5-4 and a dramatic ending for the Huskies and a very, very disappointing ending to the season for Minnesota State, who had clawed their way back into the game from a two-goal deficit, taking a lead but couldn't enhance it, and the Huskies end up outlasting Minnesota State 5-4 in regulation. And a tough ending to a very interesting year in this COVID world for Minnesota State, that they were able to put together a season, win a regular season championship, win a regional championship, and make it quite an entertaining first appearance ever in a Frozen Four.